Suddenly we saw him return, running, with terror painted on his countenance. "They are there," said he. "They have taken possession of it. Our dwelling is full of them. Oh, how frightful they are! What a blessing mamma is not there. She would have died of fright to see them enter." I confess I was much agitated, but, not wishing to expose my children to danger before I had done all in my power to prevent it, I ordered them to remain behind till I called them. I broke a branch from a tree hastily, which I held in one hand, and in the other some long nails, which I found by chance in the bottom of my pocket, and I advanced thus to my tree castle. I expected to have found the door of my staircase torn open and broken, and our new guest ascending and descending, but I saw at once it was closed as I had left it. Being of bark, it was not easily distinguished. How had these savages reached the dwelling 40 feet from the ground? I had placed planks before the great opening. They were no longer there. The greater part of them had been hurled down to the ground, and I heard such a noise in our house that I could not doubt Jack's report. I advanced timidly, holding up in the air the branch and my offerings, when I discovered, all at once, that I was offering them to a troop of monkeys, lodged in the fortress, which they were amusing themselves by destroying. We had numbers of them in the island, some large and mischievous, against whom we had had some difficulty in defending ourselves when crossing the woods, where they principally dwelt.